అంటే దానిపైన చేస్తారు సార్.
Good morning. Today we are going to discuss the next topic, the color vision and the color blindness. Along with this, we'll discuss the refractive errors also once again. Today, the learning objectives for today's session is what are the different types of cones? You know, already we have discussed in the earlier class. We have the three types of cones we have already discussed: S cone, L cone, M cone, and what are the different photo options, you know, and theories of color vision and interpretation of the color by the nervous system, and color blindness and testing of the color vision. So today we are going to discuss in this chapter today class, and these are very commonly asked in the Viva and the, even in the university examination also. Color blindness is commonly asked in the, and theories of color vision is also in the as a short notes. What are the different types of vision? You know, there are two types. One is achromatic. The sensation of the white vision with no color vision is called as the achromatic vision, and the second one is the chromatic. The chromatic, the spectral color vision. Another one is the extra spectral color vision. The spectral vision, or depending on the spectrum of the light, the spectral vision depending on the red color, red, blue, green, and the extra spectral color vision is the mixing of the two spectra. Suppose if you take the blue and red, produce the carbon color. This is the extra spectral color vision. The spectral color vision, blue, red, green, and these things are the concerned spectral color vision. And what are the different types of colors? There are two types of colors. One is the primary, another one is the complementary colors. The primary colors are the blue, green, red, and mixing of the these three colors are the primary colors. And the complementary colors, when the two colors are mixed in appropriate amount, it cancels the colors and produces a white sensation, is called as the complementary colors. The color vision by the cones, the photopigment of the cones is called a photopsin. The photopigment of the rods is called as the rhodopsin. Already we have rhodopsin, others also called as the scotopsin. We have already discussed in the previous classes. The photochemicals can all have the almost same composition that of the photopsin in the rods. The protein portion of the cones is called as the photopsin, and the protein portion of the rods is called as the scotopsin. Already we have discussed these things when you discussed when the rhodopsin splits into the 11 cis retinal split. Whenever it is activated, it splits into the 11 trans retinal and the photopsin. Again, the cis retinal is combined with the photopsin and forms the photopigment rhodopsin. The color sensitivity pigments of the cones are the combination of the retinal of the photopsins. Already we have discussed in the last class erythrolabe, cyanolabe, and chlorolabe. According to the Young and Helmholtz theory of trichromatic theory, the cones have the selective sensitive to different types of colors, the blue cone and green and the red. The only one type of three types of color pigments is present in each different cone is the according to the Young and the Helmholtz theory. Trichromatic color vision. Each cone will have a specific pigment. The three color pigments are the blue sensitive pigment, green sensitive pigment, red sensitive pigment. Discussed in the last class, the cones are normally have three types: the S cones, M cones, and the L cones. Different options differ in the few amino acids and absorb light at a different wavelength as the retinal bond. The cyanolabe or the triton, the S cones contains the cyanolabe, M cones contains the chlorolabe, L cone contains the erythrolabe, triton, deuton, and the proton. The absorption characteristics of the pigments. The blue sensitive pigments peak absorption of the light wavelength is 445. The blue sensitive, the peak is the 445 nanometers is the blue sensitive peak absorption of light wavelength is the 445 nanometer, the peak. The green sensitive pigment, the absorption peak, the green sensitive is at the 535 nanometers. The green sensitive pigment absorption is light at the 535. For the blue, it is the 445. When it comes to the red sensitive pigments, the peak absorption is the 570. It is a 570 nanometers. When it comes to the rhodopsin, the light peak absorption is the 5.5 nanometers. The blue sensitive, 445 nanometers. The green, 535. Red is the 570 nanometers. When it comes to the rhodopsin, is the 505 nanometers. Is the different wavelength characteristics of the different pigments. The theories of color vision. All the theories of color vision is based on well-known observation that human eye can detect almost all gradation of colors only when the red, green, blue monochromatic lights are appropriately mixed in different combinations. The spectral sensitivity of three types of the cones in human eyes proved to be essential for the same for the light absorption curve of the three different types of pigments that are present in the cyanolive, ethrolive, and the chloral layer. The two complementary color regions, the one is the trichromatic theory, trichromatic by the Young-Helmholtz, and the opponent process theory. Suppose if you see the how the these two theories different, how these two theories explains, the trichromatic theory is proposed by the Young and Helmholtz theory, proposed in 19th century. Where the Thomas Young and Hermann von Helmholtz proposed the three, there are three different types of cones are present, the S cones, L cones, and the M cones. The Herring proposed the opponent process theory in 1872. It states the retina has the trichromatic theory states that retina has the three types of different cones, preferentially they are sensitive to the blue, red, and green. And the several color perception phenomena cannot be explained by, this is the disadvantage of the trichromatic theory, different several color perception phenomena cannot be explained by the trichromatic theory. When you look at the opponent theory, it states that visual system is interpreted color in the antagonistic way, red versus the green, blue versus yellow, black versus white. He states that it is the opponent. The opponent theory interprets the antagonist. Activation of one member of the pair inhibits the activity of all. Suppose if the red cones are activated, the green are inhibited. Suppose blue is activated, yellow is inhibited. The complementary after images are better explained with the opponent theory proposed by the Edward Herring. Is the better explained this one. Suppose if you look at compare the trichromatic theory, the S cones will be sensitive to the blue light and the M cones are sensitive to green. L cones will be due to the red, because of the cyanolab, chlorolab, and erythrolab. The overall balance activity of the yes, the short wave, the medium wave, and the long wavelength cones determines our perception of the color according to the trichromatic theory proposed by the Young and Helmholtz. When it comes to the Herring, the opponent process theory, it is a achromatic system. When they all together, they forms the system. When all three cones are stimulated, S and M and L, they stimulated, they produce the black and white, the phenomena, the achromatic system. The chromatic system, it results of the excitatory or the inhibitory connections between the three cone types. Suppose simultaneous stimulation of the L and M cones in turn inhibits the blue cell, which results in the perception of the L. Suppose if there is a simultaneous stimulation of the S and M cones, suppose if you look at this, suppose if there is a simultaneous stimulation of the M cones and the L cones and in turn inhibit the blue cones, the S cones will result in the perception of the yellow. Suppose if the blue light is present, the S cone is activated and the cell perceives as the excitatory input and it perceived as a blue color. It perceived as a blue color. Suppose if it is inhibition, by stimulation of the L anion, some of with the inhibiting the B Y cell, it produces the yellow. Suppose if the S cone is activated and it receives the excitatory input, and it perceived as a blue, according to the opponent process theory. The trichromatic theory, cell respond positively to one of the three frequency activated. Suppose in opponent process stage, the three color channels are discovered by a nearby opponent cells. The opponent cells tuned to the luminosity are excited by the red, green, and the blue color signals. The CG cells, suppose you see the CG cells are excited by the red and the blue, and inhibited by the green. Suppose the CB cells are excited by the red and green and inhibited by the blue cells, will produce the coloration. According to the opponent theory of process, suppose if you see the opponent relationship between the red and green and the blue and yellow. Suppose if you look at this picture, suppose if you look at these four color patches if you stimulate for the 30 seconds, after that, suppose then you remove the color stimulus and becomes a white black hole. When you fix it, the dot at the center of this field, you can notice that the original colors are reversed. All of you look at this picture for 30 seconds without deviating. You concentrate on all the four colors and wait. You count the 30 numbers. Okay, we have completed the 30 seconds, and then you look at this next picture at the center. You maybe appreciate the reversing of the color images. Suppose you are not done, you can try it afterwards. Okay, where you saw the red, it becomes a green, and where you saw at the green, it becomes a red. Likewise, where you saw at the blue, it becomes yellow. Where you saw the yellow, it will become the blue, as per the opponent. When one member of the color pair is fatigued by extended inspection, the inhibition of its corresponding pair member is reduced. This is the explanation for why it occurring the reverse, because one pair is fatigued, one of the pair, color pair, suppose if the green is fatigued and the red is corresponding pair member is reduced. This increases the relative activity levels of the unfatigued pair as a result of the color perceived. Because of this, once you shift to the white, this increases the relative activity of the unpaired. Suppose, as we said, the red get fatigued, now the green will be unfatigued, the green color cones will be activated, relative activity if the color being perceived as per this one. Other theories, the Muller's doctrine of specific nerve energies, when you discuss the receptors, the specific nerve fibers with specific ganglion cell responds to the three primary colors. Because of the on response, when the green is on, the red is, because of this, the perception of the complementary colors will be seen. The positive after image, suppose if you see one color and close the eye, still that color can be seen. It is a positive after image. Negative after inhibition, suppose if you see a red plus bluish green produces sensation of the white color. While seeing the red color, suppose if you look at the white color, the complementary color, the bluish color is bluish green is seen. This is called as the negative after inhibition. The positive after image, suppose if you see one color and close the eye, still that the color can be seen. It is called as a positive after image. The negative after inhibition, suppose if you see the red plus the bluish green produces sensation of the white color. Suppose while seeing the red, suppose if you look at the white color, the complementary color, the bluish green can be seen. The other theory is the Granitz theory, according to the dominator receptors and the modulator receptors are present. Some cones will have the very wide spectrum on the all the wide spectrum, the red, blue, green, and where you have the wide spectrum, we can observe the, and some people have the very narrow spectrum, they will use, will the modulator receptors will be specific to that red, blue, and green according to the Granitz theory. Then we look at the how the nervous system interpret the these colors. Suppose if an orange monochromatic light with a wavelength of 580 nanometers stimulates the red cones, the value about 99% will be stimulated, the green cones to a value of 42, but the blue cones are not at all stimulated at, suppose if you see the ratio of stimulation of the three type of cones at this instance, the orange color light, it stimulates the 99% of the 99, the red cones, and 42 value of the green, and it won't stimulate the at all at the blue cones. The nervous system interprets this ratio sensation as the orange, 92 red and 42 green, 0 blue, interpreted the nervous system as a orange color. Okay, the interpretation of the colors is the orange monochromatic light, red cones are stimulated 98%, green cones are 42, the blue cones, the ratio stimulation is the 98, 42 and the 0 blue, red, green, and the INS, this ratio perceived by the CNS as a orange color. Suppose the interpretation of the, suppose it is with the blue light with a wavelength of 450 nanometer, it stimulates the red cones to a zero value and the green cones also zero and the blue cones 97%. The nervous system interprets as the blue, interpreted as a blue, only 97% of the blue cones and remaining the red and green are 0%. It interprets as a blue color. The red cones are zero and the green cones are not stimulated. The only blue cones are stimulated with the 97% and the ratio of stimulation 0:0:97. The CNS interprets this ratio as the blue. The interpretation of the other colors, the yellow, green, suppose the ratio, the red 83, red and green will be interpreted as a yellow, and the ratio of the red 31, 67 green and 36 blue interpreted as a green. The perception of the white light is equal. The, all the red, green, blue cones give a, and stimulated equally, they give a sensation of the white. White is a combination of the all wavelength spectrums. The perception of white can be achieved by stimulating the retina with the proper combination of the three chosen colors, the, that are the blue, red, and green. The interpretation of the colors, suppose if the ratio red 83 and the green 83, blue 0, it gives the yellow sensation. And when it stimulates the ratio of the red 37 and the green 67 and the blue 36, it gives a, the CNS sensation as a green color. The perception and the equal stimulation of all cones will give the white nothing but the spectrum of the combination. Then what is color blindness? The term color blind is a misleading, taken literally. So because the color blind people can see the colors, but cannot make out the difference between the sum of the complementary colors. The color blindness is misleading. They cannot make out the difference between the sum of the complementary colors, but they can see the colors. The color blindness, the classification is based on the John Dalton's the three receptor theory. Based on the three receptor theory, the individuals are suffering from the color blindness are classified into trichromats, dichromats, and the monochromats. Suppose if you look at the trichromats, these are the people. Will have the, they have the all the three functional three types of cones, but they have a one weakness of the one primary colors. According to one, basing on the color, the proton anomaly, the is also called proton anomalous weakness to the red color. The commonest occurrence is 6%. It is a sex linked proton anomalous weakness to the green color. The occurrence is 6%, and it is also sex-linked. Retina anomaly is a weakness, is a very rare, and it is autosomal with involving the chromosome 7. This is the how the Ishiar chart of the anomalous trichromats. This is a normal. You must be able to appreciate the number here is the 2, the protono anomaly and the tritono anomaly. They cannot appreciate the numbers here. This is how the anomalous trichromat look like. Suppose if you look at this chart, Ishiar pseudo chromatic charts, the number 7 we are able to see. The protono anomaly, tritono anomaly, they are not able to appreciate the these color. I would appreciate this one. Okay. Then color blindness, the dichromats, these are the individuals where they have the 2 functional cone systems. One of the cone system is defective. They cannot appreciate the one of the primary color. According to they are classified the protonopia blindness to the red and tritonopia blindness to the green and the tritonopia blindness to the blue. It's called the tritonopia. Protonopia red, tritonopia green and tritonopia for the blue. And then monochromats, these are the individuals where they have the only one cone system. The remaining 2 cone systems are not functioning. It is very rare occurrence. They see only black and white and the shades of gray only. This is a chart of the Ishiara charts where the dichromatics, this is how the this is the normal, the protonopia, tritonopia people looks like this. This is the Ishiara and the 7 number. This is how the protonopia, tritonopia anomalies look like. Suppose if you carefully observe this one, they can see the vaguely the 7 here. And the 2 also vaguely they will be appreciating in this in the anomaly. When you look at these charts, the anopia where you cannot appreciate the 2 or the 7 in the trichromats. That is only the in anomaly, there is a only weakness of the one of the system. Then the it is a due to congenital absence of the single group of the perception of the cones. Sometimes you may have the aquile whenever you have the retinal toxicity and damage of the cones. That most commonly the nowadays they using the hydroxychloroquine when they use it in the long term therapy for the rheumatoid arthritis. And suppose if they suffer from the using of these things, it should be hard to stop the. This is irreversible. Suppose as soon as the damage occurs, the cones damage occurs, you cannot reverse this one. Even some of the anti-tuberculous drugs, even ethambutol also produces the color vision defects. Due to congenital absence of the single group, the persons usually there will be absence of the either red or the cones. The people with the 2 functional cores of the trichromat are the people with all the functions of the trichromat already we have discussed. The persons are unable to differentiate between the green, missing either of these cones, red and the green, and absence of the green cone is called the protonopia, absence of the red cone is the protonopia. The green, orange, red, yellows have the wavelength ranging from the 525 to 675. These colors are normally distinguished from one another by the red and the green cones. Already when we have discussed the red green color blindness, it is a genetic disorder where you can commonly see in the males. The photopsins are coded on the X chromosomes. It never occurs in the females because they have the one of the X chromosome is functioning because of they have 2 X chromosomes. So that is why they acts as a carriers only. The females only acts as a color blindness. But about 8% of the 8 women are the color blindness carriers. Already we have discussed the anomaly. It is a very rare conditions. Green and red cones missing is more common. The blue cones weakness is very rare. It is genetically inherited, autosome encoded on the chromosome. The red and green blindness is a sex linked encoded on the X chromosome. And the blue weakness, it is a tetanopia. The absence of the test cones will produce the tetanopia. This is how the color, it is a normal view for the tetanope. It looks like this. This old map for tetanope, let's say the tetanope. This is how it looks like. So, air balloon, hot air balloon, the proton knob, this is the normal, the color for the blindness. This is a different color caps, suppose yellow, it is orange, green, and pink, and the blue. For the deuterium knob, it is how it looks like, and the proton knob, it looks like the this. The Ishihara charts are the pseudo-chromatic charts. It is the charts used to rapidly assessing the color vision. The charts are arranged in different spots. The charts are observed with the spectral sensitivity curves of different cones at a time. There is a 38 plates, color plates will have. The dots of the color are different shades and different numbers are hidden, different patterns are present. It is invented by the Ishihara. The Ishihara charts are made by the Japanese ophthalmologist when he is working in the military medical school. He is asked to devise the test to. He was assisted by the his colleague where he is already having an abnormality of the color vision. The blind color blind physician is helped in the assisting the him in the preparing this thing. And the Ishihara, he has the made prepared the chart. These are the different types of pseudochromatic Ishihara charts. These are the different times. So the American they are using the different. This is the standard Ishihara chart with the 38 plates. So suppose if you look at the these are all the numbers. These are the for the these patterns are for the illiterate where they have to trace out these things. The first and the last one will be this pattern. This number is appreciated by all people, including all the colorblind also. They can appreciate the whether it is a appropriate or not. They can appreciate the all the 12 and this pattern depending upon the weakness. They will have that. These are the Ishihara chart. The person with normal color vision is able to appreciate the 74, whereas the red green when he reads as a 21. This will have that. Each chart will have the number how it appreciates. Will have a different manual where you can go through the whenever you have a lesion. And we'll discuss the refractive errors again. Already we have discussed in the first class because this is a very important topic for examination point of view and for the practical also. What is the visual acuity? The visual acuity or the acuteness of vision is defined as the power of the eye able to resolve the two stimuli as a separate in the space. The minimum distance between the two stimuli at which it will be perceived as a two separate stimuli. It is determining the outline, the form and shape and even the minute details of the object also. Then what are the factors affecting the visuality? This is previously asked in the university examination. The visual acuity depends upon the sight also. Suppose if the fovea macula is damaged because of any reasons, suppose if it is a parafoveal fixation, the paramacular fixation occurs, suppose the vision will be reduced to even 6/60. Normally the visual acuity where you have the center fixation, it is a 6/6, and when we have the parafoveal fixation where it will be when vision reduced to 6/60. Visual acuity is the highest at the fovea center as the where the only cones are present, it tend to reduce the towards the periphery of the retina. The type of the stimulus, the illumination of the surface and the time of the exposure, brightness, contrast, these are the things which will affect the practice affecting the visual acuity. That is why whenever you are doing the assessment with the science chart, even you have to see the luminescence of the bulb. Suppose if it is old, you have to replace the bulb of the science chart also. And even the refractive errors also, the spherical, the chromatic aberrations also will affect the visual acuity. The chromatic aberration tend to reduce the visual acuity. Therefore, the monochromatic light increases the visual acuity. And the errors of refraction, already we have discussed the myopia, hypermetropia, astigmatism also reduces the visual acuity. Suppose if you look at the normal optical system, the ametropic eye has an axial length of the 24 mm in length. Then what is the optical axis? The line passing through the center of the curvature of the cornea to surface of the lens and meet the retina at the fovea center. It is the fovea, it is an optical axis. Then nodal point is the optical center that lies in the posterior. This is the nodal point that is lies in the posterior part of the lens. Then anterior focal distance, it is about 15 centimeters in front of the cornea. It is 15 centimeters in front of the anterior focus. It is 15 centimeters. The anterior focus is 15 centimeters from the in front of the cornea. Then there is a posterior focal distance. It is about 20 centimeters behind the cornea. It is from here, it is 24 millimeters. The anterior focal distance is 15 millimeters in front of the cornea, and the posterior focal distance is 24 millimeters behind the cornea. The lines enclosing the angle, the QPNB angle, which is called as the visual angle, the angle subtended by any object at the nodal point. This is the QNB angle. Is the angle is the visual angle. Then what is the far point and what is the near point? The far point is the farthest distance from which the eye can see the object clearly. Normally, the far point is supposed to be 20 feet or the 6 meters from the eye. It is the normal. Then what is the near point? It is the nearest distance from which eye, at which the object can be seen clearly. It is in a normal angle. It is the 25 centimeters or approximately 10 inches from the eye. The far point is, it is located 20 feet or the 6 meters, and the near point is 25 centimeters or the 10 inches from the eye. Then accommodation, the range of accommodation is the distance between the far point and the near point is called as the range of accommodation. From the 6 meters distance to the 25 centimeters is the range of accommodation. Then what is the amplitude of accommodation? The amplitude of accommodation is the difference between the refractive power of the lens with the ciliary muscles are maximally contracted and ciliary muscles are complete. When the ciliary muscles are maximally contracted, the refractive power is 29 diopters, and when the ciliary muscles are completely relaxed, it is 15 diopters for a young patient. The amplitude of accommodation is 14 diopters. This amplitude of accommodation decreases with the age, and in the presbyopia at the age of 70 years, it is almost nearer to the zero. The emetropia, already we have discussed the condition in which the ciliary muscles completely relax. The parallel rays of light coming from distant object focused on the treat is an emetropia. The hypermetropia condition, when the ciliary muscle is completely relaxed, the parallel rays are coming at a distant object, or the lens system is inefficient to refract, and these will be focused behind the retina. The parallel rays are focused behind retina. Because of the too short or the weak lens system, this is happens. When you look at the far point and the near point of the hypermetropia, the far point is the same as the emetropic, but the near point is away from the eye. It is the near point is away from the, it is more than the 25 centimeters or the 10 inches. Then what is myopia? The refractive error used when the ciliary muscles are completed, the parallel rays of coming focus in front of the retina. It is because here the lens refractive system is more, or because of increased refractive system, or there is a too big eye, because axial myopia, where you have the more or the increase in the curvature of the this cornea also causes the refraction of the lights in front of the retina. And look at the far point, near point of the myopic person, which is nearer to compared to that of a normal. And both the far point and the near point is nearer to the eye compared to that of a emetropic individual. Sigma means a point. Estimate is an error in which light rays cannot be brought to a point of focus on the retina. The astigmatism is a defect of the refractive power of the eye in one plane only. It is because of an oblong shape of the cornea, most commonly due to the difference in the curvature of the horizontal and the vertical curvature of the cornea. Due to oblong shape, degree of curvature, long axis, the refractive two types of curvature are the index astigmatism because of the change in the index of the lens also because of the old age also can cause the index increase in the change in the astigmatism also. Astigmatism is corrected by the cylindrical lenses. We can correct them. What are the different physiological aberration? The spherical, orthochromatic, and the diffraction. The diffraction refers to the bending of light rays caused by the edge of the aperture or the rim of the lens. Suppose if you edge of the aperture, if it is a edge of the pupil, the iris, edge of the iris, the pupil, or the rim of the lens, the actual pattern of the diffracted image points produced by a lens will be the circular aperture or a pupil is a series of concentric bright and the dark rings with the bright spot in the center. Suppose this is how the with the diffraction the it will have the brightest point followed by the dark. This is how the with the diffraction is the one of the physiological aberrations. Then all the physiological other the spherical aberrations and the chromatic aberrations. In a convex lens, for instance, only the parallel rays near to the axis will meet the principal focus. The rays further away from the axis, however, refracted too much, so they cut the axis near to the lens than the principal focus. Thus, they causing the blurring of the edges of the image. This is how the spherical lens they don't because they have refracted more because of the greater refraction at the periphery. The spherical lenses. Than the compared to the center of their eye supply, they don't produce a point focus. They don't produce a exactly. This is the spherical. This will can be prevented by the change in the size of the pupil size. Can prevent the these things. Then another aberration is the chromatic aberration. When the light made up of all different spectrum, the component of rays refracted differently. Short to the long. Is the ultraviolet is along with the red rays. Hence, there is a tendency of white light being split into the its component, in which case the image have a color, just the chromatic aberrations. The chromatic aberrations, again, the axial chromatic aberrations and the lateral, the periphery is the chromatic aberrations. So this and the blue light, it will be refracted in front and the red, it will be refracted back. Okay, the chromatic aberration, the optic system, the eye represents a simple lens system. The yellow light is focused on the retina. Suppose if you think the yellow light is focused on the retina, the eye is myopic for the blue light. Suppose if you think the yellow is focused, the blue is myopic and red is hypermetropic for the. This is the for the. Normal chromatic aberrations that can occur in the anterior, but because of the decrease in the size of the pupil size, where only the center part will be of the lens is involved, where it will prevent the both the spherical and the chromatic aberrations. Suppose if you look at this picture, the distance picture, this suppose if you see there is a pinkish hue here and there is a yellow tinge here. This can be removed by using the software where after that removing the chromatic aberration. This is how the picture is, original picture is, because of the chromatic aberrations. So this is how it looks. Suppose if you look at this picture above here, suppose if you see there is a green and the purple hue here also, there will be a purple hue after the application of the removal of the chromatic aberrations. These green and the purple edges are removed from the picture. There are emitter axial because of the abnormal length of the eye. They are called as the axial emmetropia, too long in myopia, too short in hypermetropia. Then other one is the curvatural emmetropia. This is the abnormal curvature of the refracting surface of the cornea or the lens. There is too weak in hypermetropia, too strong in hypermyopia. Then other one is the index emmetropia. There is an abnormal increase in the refractive index. There is increase in the refractive index in myopia. There is a decrease in the index will cause the hyper. Already we have discussed as with the age, the refractive index increases will produce the second sight because of lenticular sclerosis. Even the presbyopia feel like the presbyopia has disappeared. The axial increase in the anthropocentric diameter of the globe is the most common cause of the myopia. The curvature, increase in curvature of the scene whenever you have the ectasia because of the suppose if you think of the keratoconus, where there will be thinning of the anterior surface of the cornea and will lead to the keratoconus. And the lens, because of the lenticonus, also produce the curvature. The index increase in the refractive index of the lens. It occurs in the senile nuclear cataract, where there is an increase in the index of the refractive index, produce the index myopia. Other types of the myopia are the congenital, or the developmental, or the simple myopia, or the pathological. Suppose if the refractive power more than minus 80 diopters, it is called as the pathological myopia. Then hypermetropia, the axial, there is a too short eyeball, the curvature of the lens because of the flat curvature of the cornea will produce the hypermetropia. Steep curvature of the cornea produce the myopia. Then when there is a increase in the refractive index of the cortex, suppose that's seen in the diabetic or the senile type of cataract, where the increase in the refractive index of the cortex will produce the hypermetropia. Other types of the myopia are the latent hypermetropia, manifest again is divided into facultative, absolute types. So, you know, this much is more than sufficient. Then the astigmatism, with the rule astigmatism, the vertical meridian is more covered compared to the horizontal. It is normal in with the rule astigmatism. The types of astigmatism, whether it is a regular, in the regular is a simple, compound, or mixed, or the irregular astigmatism. The simple means only you have the only astigmatism only. The compound means they were both the spherical and the and you have the cylindrical, or it is called as the compound astigmatism. The mixed, suppose if you have hypermetropia in one axis and other axis, if you have the myopia, it is called as mixed astigmatism. Irregular astigmatism, whenever you have the corneal scars because of trauma, will produce the irregular astigmatism. For irregular astigmatism, the contact lens is the best option for that as a treatment choice. Then what are the different methods of correction of these refractive errors? The first and most commonly used the spectacles. The other one is the contact lens for like as a cosmetic, and it has the advantages. The contact lenses where you require even less power compared to the spectacles, and it will prevents the both the spherical and the chromatic aberrations. When the if you use the spectacles where you have the both the chromatic and the spherical aberrations will occur with the spectacles, that can be minimized with the contact lenses. You have a comfort of you can do that, and sometimes you may not be able to see the with the edges, but when you have wearing the contact lens, you can easily you can move as a normal light. Other things are the corneal refractive surgeries. Nowadays it is most commonly the LASIK. The first the corneal refractive surgeries earlier is the arc radial keratotomy. The is to them the peripheral they used to give the radial lines, and nowadays it is the PRK, the photokeratectomy, followed by the LASIK laser in situ keratomyelitis, and now the LASIK epithelial the another procedure LASIK and LASIK. Now they are using the intraocular lenses also, or even they are using the intact. So now they are inserting the lenses in the layers of the cornea also intact. So they are using the another one is the intraocular lens, the phakic lenses. Even they are doing the surgeries and they are keeping the phakic IOLs to correct the refractive errors. But for doing the LASIK or LASIK. You must have the sufficient corneal thickness to correct the refractive errors. This is a refractive error, so used to different lenses to correct the different refractive errors. This is a cylindrical lens, is a total cylinder, where this is how the convex cylinder or the concave cylinder looks like.